work on water that falls from the sky and ends up in rivers, so natural water cycles. And I work on water that's in people's pipes, so drinking water that people are using every day. And I work on sewage side of water as well, so the things that people flush or the storm water that ends up in the treatment systems. So the impact is in improving our technologies for water treatment and in improving decisions we make upstream of that treatment. So should we allow a certain contaminant to enter the water? Should we allow a new user to come in and use a large amount of water? How should we manage the water that agriculture is taking and energy is taking versus what we're taking at our households? So a few years ago, we were doing research in the Monongahela. We've been looking at the Monongahela for a long time. It's been an industrial river a long time. We were interested in how the different discharges of wastewater into that river were affecting the river. So we were investigating that and we started to notice some changes in the river. And we determined that those changes were associated with a new industry that had come to the region, which was oil and gas development, specifically in the Marcellus Shale Formation. And the wastewater being produced from that was going to treatment facilities that didn't take out all the contaminants. So in the river, we were seeing these increasing concentrations of a chemical that was pretty benign for the river, but was a problem for the drinking water utilities. So once we started reporting on that chemical and talking with the Department of Environmental Protection and talking with the drinking water utilities, the DEP, the Department of Environmental Protection, decided to take action on that immediately and asked the oil and gas producers to stop discharging those wastewaters into the river. A lot of my work now, where I look at drinking water systems, is looking at how they're intersecting with these energy systems. So in this region, that's often a power plant that is in the basin upstream on the river from a drinking water plant, and how those discharges from an energy system are affecting the intakes to the drinking water. Having these different areas of wastewater and drinking water and river water really limits how you can think about the actual water moving around. The water is all connected. All of those different water systems are integrated with each other. It's important for us as engineers to think of them as an integrated system of water resources so that we can better manage both how much water you need and the quality of water you need in different places and over different times.